In this video, friends, I am going to discuss the 9 tattvas of Jainism with you. The previous video on Jainism I have already uploaded, in which I have told you all the important factors about Jainism. Here, the slight spiritual ideology and basically what teachings are included in this Jainism philosophy, that will be discussed by me, friends. So this is presented by me, Harshit Divedi. If you want to follow me, friends, the link of my Instagram profile is given in the description box below. This video is in English. If you want to watch the Hindi version of the video, the link of that is also given below. See, friends, the very first thing you need to understand about Jain philosophy is that Jain philosophy doesn't believe in a supreme divine creator. For example, in the Hindu mythology, there is a god. Everybody believes in that Bhagwan. So they think that there is a god, there is a Bhagwan to save them. So there is the existence of a divine creator. But in Jainism, there is no such divine creator, no such supreme divine creator. So in this sense, it was very different from the Vedic religion. As far as the 9 truths, 9 tattvas of this Jainism religion are concerned, so they are basically the Nav-Tattva, soul, jeev first, then matter, ajeev, then merit, punya, then pap, influx of karma known as Asrava, stoppage of karmic matter known as Samvara, then bondage is Bandha, shedding of karmic matter is Nirjara, liberation Moksha. So the very first thing you need to do is, friends, that you need to remember these things, 9 things: jeev, ajeev, punya, pap, Asrava, Samvara, Bandha, Nirjara, Moksha. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 things. The very first thing I'm going to explain you is soul, friends. Okay. Now the first thing you got to know from here is that Jainism clearly accepts the theory of soul. It says that yes, soul exists. But Jainism has displayed soul and matter as independent entities. This means that soul can exist independently, jeev can exist independently, soul and jeev are the same thing here, and matter can exist independently. So kindly keep this in mind that in Jainism, soul and jeev are the same thing. In the Hindu mythology, this can be different, friends. Okay, because there jeev becomes the living and soul is obviously the soul. So basically, what is said here, that according to Jainism philosophy, the soul, this jeev, engages in some deeds. It does some work here. And that work may be good, that work may be bad. And it will depend on that work whether he is going to get moksha or not, friends. Okay? So basically, the jeev is the bhokta here, because whatever the jeev is going to do, he will get that in return. The next thing we are going to say is the ajeev, which is known as non-soul. Now, what this non-soul says, friends? Non-soul says that this says, for example, this non-says consists of dharma tattva, it consists of adharma tattva, it consists of akash, it consists of kal, it consists of pudgala. Now these things I have also discussed previously. In the previous video, I have discussed these things with you. Kindly notice very clearly, friends, this dharma is basically medium of motion. This adharma is basically medium of rest. This akash is actually space. Akash is space, or the place where we are learning. Kala is time and pudgala is matter. So the very first three things, dharma, adharma and akash, these three things don't have a form. They are actually formless. Kal is actually time, so time pervades the whole universe. Pudgal, matter is one thing which we can see, which we can feel, which we can see the color of, which we can taste. So basically, these are the things which are comprised in non-soul. So pudgal, matter, is a matter of non-soul, ajeev. It comprises dharma tattva, adharma tattva, kal, akash and pudgal, friends. Next comes the punya and the pap. Punya means good doings and pap means bad doings. As simple as that. There is nothing much to explain in pap and punya. Next is asrava, and this is very important from the perspective of Jainism, which is known as influx of karma. You need to understand asrava, friends. What is said in asrava? See, if you imagine that on a water, some boat is going on, and if you make a hole in that boat, then obviously the water will start gushing inside the boat. Similarly, our is a soul, and if you can say, hole is there, then continuously the karmic matter will enter the soul. Karmic matter will enter the soul. And when this karmic matter enters the soul, this basically becomes what? This basically becomes Asrava. Asrava is actually karma influx. Influx of karma. This is Asrava. Next thing is Samvara. This is actually the opposite of Asrava. Samvara means stoppage of karmic matter. Now what does this Samvara says? This karmic matter which is entering the soul, some sort of mechanism should be deployed so that this entering of karmic matter inside the soul can be stopped. Ceasing the inflow of karmic matter inside the soul. And basically this Samvara you can do by, you know, following a good practice in your daily life, living a simple life, eating simple food, practicing self-control on yourself, you know, you can say controlling your sensual and desirable pleasure. So these things of these type of things are just living a simple life is basically the main means of achieving Samvara, stoppage of karmic matter. Next is Bandha, bondage. Now what is Bandha, friends? Bandha says that basically this soul or jeev, this jeev is connected to matter, which is Pudgal. So basically here, this soul is connected to a non-soul thing. So when this soul is connected to a non-soul thing, it becomes a bondage. It becomes Bandha. Okay. Next is Nirjara. Nirjara. Nirjara means removing the karmic matter, destroying the karmic matter. So Nirjara becomes very important, friends, because whatever karma which is entering inside your soul, you have actually finally, in order to achieve moksha, you have to remove that karma. And basically that removal process, that cleaning process, that destruction process of the karmic matter, this is basically known as Nirjara. The next thing which we are going to see is moksha, friends. Moksha means finally we are going to get liberation from this cycle of continuous birth and death. So for that you have to remove all karmic matter. And this can be done when your, you can say, soul is at the highest level. When you are having the perfect amount of knowledge, you are having kevalya gan. So in order to attain moksha, you should have three things: right faith, right knowledge, and right conduct. So these are the triratna of Jainism. Triratna of Jainism: right knowledge, right faith, and right conduct. If you are going to practice these three things together, you are going to achieve moksha. Now, right conduct can be achieved by some vows. Some vows which are known as Mahavratas. Now what are these Mahavratas? First is non-violence, which is known as ahimsa. Non-violence. Second is, you very well know the meaning of ahimsa, friends, I don't need to explain. Second is satya. You should be truthful to the society, to everyone who is surrounding you. Next is brahmacharya. Brahmacharya means that you should not indulge in sexual or sensual pleasures. You should live a life of a monk, brahmacharya. Next is Asteya. Asteya means that you should not steal from someone. Anyone else's thing, you should not take it. Until and unless he himself is giving that thing to you. Okay, and that thing too should not be too luxurious. Because when the Jain monks were begging, they were actually begging for things which were of daily use. For example, food, eating, clothes. So for these things they were begging, not for everything. Then the next thing is Aparigriha. Aparigriha means that you are not having any greed. And by saying greed not only from the sense of wealth, actually from sense of everything. For example, you should have no social bonding, no social attraction, no greed of any sort. So Aparigriha. So basically, what are the five Mahavratas? Ahimsa, Satya, Brahmacharya, Asteya, Aparigriha. So what does this Jain religion is saying? That every soul has very divine qualities. It is actually capable of attaining kevalya gan, okay, and finally attain moksha. So this is the basic behind this complete lecture, friends. So I hope this video was helpful for you. These 9 tattvas are very much clear to you. So watch this video, and in addition to this, please watch this video on important facts of Jainism. So both of them will complete Jainism from the perspective of exams. All your questions will be covered. So I hope this video is helpful. Kindly share these videos on your Facebook and Instagram profile, and please subscribe to the channel. Also like the video, and please tell me through your comments your thoughts. Goodbye.